You're backing Rebecca Long Bailey.
Yeah.
What do you make of the contest so far?
Well, I think they're all very good candidates, let's be clear. I think that the advantage we would have with Rebecca Long Bailey is that she's a great supporter of the movement. I mean, when...
What do you mean by the movement?
The Labour movement. And when Keir and Lisa stood down from the shadow cabinet in an attempt to force Jeremy Corbyn out, Becky stood by the member's choice, and that says something about her. I also think she brings some of the best characteristics of the other two. So, for instance, she's a lawyer, like Keir, so she has that very forensic approach to policy and is very good on detail. She comes from the north of England, like Lisa, and therefore she really understands how people felt, many of them long-standing Labour voters that didn't feel able to support us in the past. And she's also the person that has constructed one of our most important and popular policies, the Green New Deal. So she's the one for me.
I'm interested to talk about how, when you were saying she's a supporter of the movement, mm-hmm. are you worried that if Keir Starmer or Lisa Nandy wins over Rebecca Long Bailey, that they'll move away from Corbynism?
I'm not saying that, but I am saying when times were tough and other people were stepping down from the front bench, Becky stood by the members' choices leader, and I think that's important.
I mean, Lisa Nandy, for example, when she's addressed the fact that she stood down, has said that part of the reason was because she was worried about the way anti-Semitism was investigated. So she would say that standing by and doing nothing was the wrong thing to do.
Well, I understand her saying that, but I was there at the time, and I know why. I know what people like Lisa and Keir said about standing down. But, you know, I don't want to talk about the past, but I want to talk about the importance of loyalty and the importance of the qualities that Becky will bring to the leadership.
Were they disloyal at the time?
I wouldn't want to say that, but, I mean, they did step down.
OK.
And Becky didn't.
OK. Who's your second preference going to?
Well, I'm not thinking about a second preference. For me, it's Becky.
OK. OK, would it be a shame if Labour didn't elect a woman leader?
Well, I've been a campaigning feminist for 30 years, so of course I would like to see a woman leader. It's a little bit embarrassing that the Tories have had two women leaders and we haven't, have only never, ever had one. So that's part of why I'm supporting Becky. Not the most important thing, but it's one of the reasons I'm supporting Becky.
So do you think it would be a bit embarrassing if the man won again?
I don't think it'll be embarrassing exactly, but, you know, we are long overdue a woman leader, and I think Becky is the right choice.
I want to talk about the election loss, the worst result for Labour since 1935. Why do you think that devastating result happened?
Well, some of the causes of our loss, particularly the erosion of our vote in the north and coalfield communities and so on, actually predate the Jeremy Corbyn leadership. I mean, the erosion of our support in some of those communities was going on under New Labour.
But at the same time, the erosion of that support, they were votes that Tony Blair won in 1997.
He did win, but the vote was eroding and continued to do so. This was our, very sadly, this
you
was
You can't
our,
blame New Labour, surely, for
no,
the last election.
No, the point I'm making, this was our fourth failure to win an election on the trot. So you can't blame it entirely on the Corbyn leadership.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly...
Was the Corbyn leadership partly to blame? Will you accept that?
Well, you know, I ran in Hackney North, and in Hackney North, they loved Jeremy Corbyn, so I'm
I can imagine. I can imagine that they did. When I went out to different parts of the country, not London, during the election campaign, his name came up an awful lot.
Well, it would do, because, I mean, I have never you know, and I've been an MP for 30 years, seen the sort of attack on a Labour leader that Jeremy Corbyn had to endure. I mean, a really unpleasant attack.
But so, why would that... Why are you saying voters are more gullible outside of London then? I don't understand why that would be any different in Hackney North or in Dudley North.
Well, it's a bit different in Hackney North because we're next door to Islington North, so a lot of them know Jeremy. No, it was a very difficult campaign. Jeremy had to withstand terrible attacks in the media. There was the issue of anti-Semitism, which people felt hadn't been dealt with adequately, rightly or wrongly. But it was part of a downturn in the Labour vote, which goes all the way back to 2010.
Some listening may think that you just haven't learned the lessons from that defeat. You're defending Jeremy Corbyn, talking about attacks in the media. You, of course, said that when it comes to Brexit, Labour should have been even more unequivocally Remain during that referendum. You're talking about New Labour and losses that have been happening over decades. Have you really come to terms with what happened?
Yeah, no.